In this video, we're going to look at possessive adjectives in Icelandic, which we use to indicate who something belongs to in a sentence. So we have both possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives, but in this video we'll focus on the adjectives. So this is our full set of adjectives and pronouns. We have them there in the first person, second person and third person, in the singular and the plural. The first form we have those minn, my, thinn, your, singular, and then in the plural we have okkar, our, ykkar, your, plural. And in the third person there we just have one form, which is sinn, for the singular and the plural, which can be translated as his, her, its, or their, depending on the context. Now, what's different about these three, minn, thinn, and sinn, is that they decline for gender, number, and case. So they behave a lot like adjectives, which is why we call them possessive adjectives in this context. So let's have a look at the forms of these three possessive adjectives. We have them there in the nominative and accusative case, in the masculine, feminine and neuter. So if we take a look at through the first one there, minn, we see that it changes to minn in the accusative, masculine. In the feminine nominative it's minn, accusative, minna. And then in the neuter, we have mitt for both cases there. So if we add the plurals here, then we get minir, minar, and minn in the nominative, and minna, minar, and minn in the accusative. And we can see that it's only the masculine there that has different form in the accusative. So these two forms are the same, as are these two. And then in the plural, the feminine and the neuter plural are the same in both cases there. All right, so what about the other two, thinn and sinn? Well, actually, if we have a look here, it's just a case of changing the first letter. The M becomes þorr, so minn becomes thinn. Mean becomes thinn, and so on. So nothing changes there except the first letter. And then for sinn, we can probably guess what's going to happen there. So if we have a look, same thing there, just that first letter is changing and all of the other forms are the same. Okay, so this is our full set that we have so far. Now, the third person, it seems a bit strange that it just has this one form, considering it can mean his, her, its, or their. We actually have a parallel set of forms. Hans, hennar, þess, and þeirra. Hans meaning his, hennar meaning her, þess meaning its, and þeirra meaning their. So what's the difference between those four forms and sinn? Well, sinn is what we call the reflexive form. What this means is that it refers back to the subject of the sentence. And then the other forms are non-reflexive. So they refer to someone that is not mentioned in that sentence or that part of the sentence, that clause. So that's the primary difference there. A good rule of thumb is that sinn can never be the subject of a sentence. So if you have a sentence, something like his car is old, that his there can never be translated as sinn. You'd have to use hans in that example. So if we take our first example to have a look at how sinn works in practice. we have this sentence, Magnus drekkur kaffi sitt. Magnus drinks his coffee. So Magnus is the subject of the sentence, and kaffi sitt is the object of the verb drekkur, drinks. So sitt there refers back to Magnus. If we compare it to this sentence, Magnus drekkur kaffið hans, Magnus drinks his coffee would also be the translation of that into English. Hans there, well, it doesn't refer to Magnus, it refers to another male that we can't see in this sentence. So it refers to a han, a he, but they're not mentioned in this sentence. So the difference in meaning is that in the first sentence, Magnus is drinking his own coffee, but in the second sentence, he's drinking someone else's coffee. Let's take another example. Börnin borða morgunmatinn sinn. The children eat their breakfast. So sinn here is masculine singular accusative because it agrees with morgunmatinn, which is also masculine singular accusative. Börnin is not though. Börnin is plural, neuter, nominative. So we see that it's not agreeing grammatically with the subject of the sentence, it's agreeing grammatically with the object of the sentence. And it doesn't matter that börn is neuter. The gender of the possessor is not indicated in any way with sinn. Sinn agrees in gender with the object that is being described. Sinn nevertheless refers back to börnin, as börnin is the subject of the sentence. If we take a similar comparison to our last one, Börnin borða morgunmatinn þeirra, the children eat their breakfast. We have the same thing going on here with their. Their doesn't refer to the children, but it refers to a group of people that is not mentioned in this sentence. Okay, let's take one last example now to just underline the point about gender agreement. So, Börnin borða samlokurnar sínar. Börnin borða samlokurnar sínar. The children eat their sandwiches. So, samloka is a feminine noun, and it's plural there, and it's also in the accusative, and that is reflected in sínar, which is also feminine, plural, accusative. But as we already know, börnin is neuter. So you can see there quite clearly that the gender is not agreeing with the subject of the sentence. But sínar does refer back to börnin, the subject. So let's take all of these examples together. So the first one we have there is Magnus drekkur kaffi sitt versus Magnus drekkur kaffi hans. In the first one, it's his own coffee. In the second one, it's someone else's coffee. The fact that it's hans shouldn't confuse us into thinking that it's Magnus. There, it's just coincidental that hans is the same gender as Magnus. It could be hennar, it could be þess, it could be þeirra. So that's something to watch out for. The second example, Börnin borða morgunmatinn sinn versus Börnin borða morgunmatinn þeirra. Morgunmatinn is singular. The children eat their breakfast. We could probably have it in the plural there, but it's more natural to have it in the singular. In English, we can also have it in the singular there. So even though each child has their own breakfast, the grammatical form of the noun is singular. And then in that second sentence there, Börnin borða morgunmatinn þeirra, that þeirra shouldn't lead us to believe that it refers to börnin. So they are coincidentally plural there. It could be hans, it could be hennar, it could be þess. And then the final example there where we have both a plural subject and a plural object, but we can see because of their difference in gender that sinnar is agreeing with samlokurnar and not börnin. So if we look at some examples now of things that that don't work, kaffi sitt vont. This isn't an ungrammatical sentence in Icelandic. As we mentioned before, the sinn possessive adjective can never be part of this subject of the sentence, and the subject of this sentence is kaffi. So we would need to replace sitt with the relevant form hans, hennar, or þess, or þeirra. And the hans, hennar, þess, they agree in gender with the possessor. So here I have to know whether the possessor is male, female, neuter, or plural. In the second example here, we have another ungrammatical sentence. Morgunmaturinn sinn tilbúinn. Same thing as before. Sinn is part of the subject of the sentence and therefore is ungrammatical. So we need to replace it with hans, hennar, þess or þeirra as applicable. And a final similar example, samlokurnar sínar eru gyrnilegar. Sínar has nothing to refer back to there. So this is not a grammatical sentence in Icelandic. So correct examples of these would be kaffi hans vont. His coffee is bad. Morgunmaturinn þeirra tilbúinn. Their breakfast is ready. Samlokurnar þeirra gyrnilegar. Their sandwiches are good or tasty. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.